This week in space news, we're focusing on several exciting developments. The exploration company, a European startup, has received a huge amount of money in a new financing round, helping them to complete their contract with ESA to transport cargo to the International Space Station. Moving on, Latitude, a French space startup, has inked a multi-launch deal with ATMOS from Germany, aiming to enhance space logistics. After that, we cover Gravitics, providing a glimpse into the future with their interior renders of the space station modules. And finally, Vast, an American company, showcases progress with photos of their space station being constructed in-house. Okay, let's get started. Nick's heading to space in 2028 with $160 million funding boost for Maiden Voyage. This week, the exploration company, which was founded in 2021, revealed they've successfully closed a Series B funding round, securing a €151.6 million, that's about $160 million, to further the development of the Nix spacecraft. This brings their total funding to nearly $230 million. Nix, a modular spacecraft with three variants, Nix Earth, Nix Gateway, and Nix Moon, is designed for versatile space missions. The Nix Earth variant is set to transport cargo to the International Space Station, a mission for which they received a contract from ESA in 2024. The first flight of Nix Earth is anticipated in 2028, thanks to this new influx of funds. The Nix Gateway variant is engineered for operations in cislunar space, potentially docking with Gateway or lunar landers in orbit around the Moon. While the Nix Moon variant is developed for lunar landings, the funding helps not only spacecraft development and testing, but also allows for an expansion of their current 200-strong workforce, and allows them to scale their operations. Over the past 12 months, we have hit major operational and financial milestones and signed significant service contracts with both space agencies and commercial clients, said Helene Hubi, co-founder and CEO of the exploration company. This new funding is the next step in scaling up our ambitions. Looking ahead, the next milestone for the exploration company is the launch of their second demonstrator, named Mission Possible, scheduled for 2025. This capsule will mark the first time customer payloads are sent into orbit, with the launch being on a SpaceX Falcon 9. Okay, on to another European space startup that's been in the news this week. Latitude signs a multi-launch agreement with German space logistics company ATMOS. Latitude, a French launch provider, has entered into a multi-launch agreement with ATMOS Space Cargo, a German space logistics firm, to send ATMOS's Phoenix re-entry vehicles into very low Earth orbit. Latitude is developing the Zephyr, a two-stage rocket capable of sending up to 200 kilos into low Earth orbit, with its first launch expected by the end of 2025, and the initial commercial flight in 2026, for which the French Space Agency is the first customer. ATMOS aims to support research, technological demonstrations, and in-space manufacturing with its Phoenix capsule, which can carry 100 kilos and stay in orbit for up to 3 months, offering regular services. The agreement states that Latitude will provide at least 5 dedicated launches per year for ATMOS from 2028 to 2032. This new commercial milestone underpins the Zephyr's commercial traction. We're proud to have earned the trust of a unique operator in the European space industry, said Adeline Pitros, head of sales at Latitude. This demonstrates also that Zephyr is particularly well adapted to the growing low Earth orbit and very low Earth orbit markets. Latitude has now signed 3 launch contracts this year as they gear up for Zephyr's debut and aim to build their market presence in the competitive small satellite launcher market. Okay, on to our next story on a US space station module builder. Gravitics shows new renders of its space modules. Space station startup Gravitics has released new renders showcasing the interiors of their 4-meter and 8-meter diameter space station modules. These modules are built to be flexible, allowing for customization to meet specific mission needs or to host a variety of functions within a single pressurized spacecraft. The modules can be integrated into a commercial space station or operate as independent free-flying units. Let's look at the different types of modules available from Gravitics. Logistics. Cargo resupply missions to the International Space Station are a great example of the increasing reliance on space-based logistics for sustaining human presence beyond Earth. Arena. microgravity entertainment venues present an opportunity to captivate audiences with awe-inspiring gravity-defying spectacles. These unique environments can host a wide range of events, from sporting competitions and live concerts to immersive theatrical productions and cinematic experiences that push the boundaries of creativity. Orbital Data Center. With Earth observation and communication services dominating the space industry, demand for in-space data centers and the value of being able to process data in orbit continues to grow. Manufacturing. The microgravity environment of space provides an ideal setting for manufacturing advanced materials with exceptional purity and structural integrity. This capability will lead to invaluable advancements in various areas, including semiconductor technology, enabling the development of faster, more efficient, and more powerful electronic devices. Orbital Garage. Housing assets in space enables flexible mission profiles and the ability to bypass launch delays. Resource Depot or Fuel Depot. The establishment of propellant depots in orbit represents a pivotal step towards enabling sustainable and cost-effective space exploration. The gas stations of space extend mission durations, facilitate lunar and interplanetary architectures, and pave the way for historic crewed missions. Hub. With launch costs dropping and a new era in commercial space activity on the horizon, space stations expand opportunities for research, manufacturing, and tourism. This fosters a thriving economy and paves the way for humans to thrive beyond our home planet. Biotech. The microgravity environment offers a promising platform for biomanufacturing, enabling the production of pharmaceuticals, drugs, and even human tissues with superior quality and efficacy. This capability is leading the development of novel therapies and treatments for a wide range of diseases and is set to transform healthcare and improve life expectancy. Suites. Humans need large living spaces. The staterooms concept provides private chambers to be coupled with common space in a neighboring module. Gravitics does not aim to launch a commercial space station. Rather, they want to build modules for these space stations. The idea seems to be paying off as they have picked up two contracts so far. The first is with Axiom Space. Gravitics was awarded a $125 million contract in July 2024 to provide Axiom with a module for their planned commercial space station. It's likely this will be a utility-type module for storage. In addition, they received a US Space Force contract in April 2024 to adapt their designs for military applications. The contract was worth $1.7 million, so this is only for design work. Still, it bodes well for Gravitics that future orders from the Space Force could be on the horizon. Now, let's move on to our final story of the week. VAST updates. We've got quite a few updates from VAST this week. First was an ex-post on their life support system. It stated, "Our oxygen system trays are heading to our MOHAV site for flight-like O2 testing. This vital system is designed to keep astronauts safe by replenishing oxygen as they breathe. Each step brings us closer to creating a sustainable environment for long-duration missions on Haven 1 and beyond." The second update from VAST is that they have signed an MOU, or Memorandum of Understanding, with the Czech Ministry of Transport. Both parties will explore ways to partner on future human spaceflight projects, whether through private astronaut missions to the International Space Station or on missions to VAST's own Haven space stations. The Czech government is looking at ways to stimulate growth in the Czech space industry and to inspire young people to pursue careers in science and technology. "We are thrilled to join forces with the Czech space mission and explore joint space flight opportunities to bring science, research, and technology from the Czech industry to orbit, as well as potentially fly a Czech astronaut to the International Space Station or Haven 1 aboard a SpaceX Dragon spacecraft," said Max Hout, VAST CEO. And the final piece of news from VAST this week is an update on the construction of their first space station, Haven 1. It's been a while since the US built a primary structure for a space station, and VAST is at the forefront of this revival, constructing their modules themselves. The primary structure forms the backbone of the station, consisting of outer walls, internal supports, and frames designed to maintain the module's integrity against conditions such as launch forces, the vacuum of space, and extreme temperatures. Essentially, it's a pressure vessel that keeps the atmosphere inside, while keeping the vacuum of space outside. Currently, this structure is in final welding phase at VAST's facility. After welding, it will head to the Mohave test site for a critical stress test, ensuring it can endure the rigorous conditions of space travel and operations. Okay, that's it for this week. Thanks for watching. Be sure to like and subscribe so you'll see our upcoming videos. We make videos every week covering the space industry, with an emphasis on the smaller space startups that aren't covered so well on other channels. See you soon.